So I tried these in my Whole Foods video with Keenan. I actually went and bought more snacks, but I really did like these. They just didn't really taste cheesy to me, but they're good. I gotta figure out what they look like. It's little pieces of kale. So they said they air fry it, and they say air dried. I'm gonna try air fried. It's literally nothing bad in here. So I'm trying to save money because usually I go out to eat. I go out for lunch, I'll eat whatever, wings, 4 for $4, chicken salad chick, Panera. It doesn't matter. I don't care how much it costs. I'm eating out. But since I literally bought those meals from the woman, I brought one today. And I brought one for lunch today. And I have 8 more left. I put them in the freezer since, you know, it's kind of like it's food. And if I want it to last longer, I need to preserve it better depending on when I want to eat it. So put them all in the freezer. And I think I'm going to make some tea. So this is my little snack and tea section. So I have teas here. My coworker gave me these nice ones because I was making tea like every day. They look really cool. They're in really cute little bags. Really fancy. So this is fancy tea. And I don't really use sugar, so I don't know. I think I want to try the ginger. But these are so good. All of them are so good. I haven't tried the blueberry. I use agave. Nectar, I need to buy more because I use way too much. I want to use way too much. I have snacks. Almonds. Fruits. And then just stuff, but I want tea. I'm gonna grab this. Come into the break room, got a mask up, and put some water. About 1 liter in here because I think it's just me. Let's go back, make some tea. Dang, I don't have my badge. Somebody's gonna have to let me in. This is the raspberry zinger. It's really good. I have 1 left. Sometimes I'll make tea and just let it get cold, and it's just like something nice to have to drink. Okay, so getting my lunch together. We have chicken, corn, and green beans. I even brought some lemon pepper from home. And yeah, green beans taste good, but
Y'all know me. Put a little lemon pepper and everything. So I'm just get that together. I sampled the chicken, and that tastes really good as well. Just want to make sure that it's done. Whew, it's hot. Okay. Because it was frozen, so it took a little longer. Okay. I think we're good. Package this up.
So I'm back in my car, and I have my food. I actually like eating in my car. Usually, today is such a nice day. When it's nice like this, sometimes I may even, like, go for a nice walk at like a park or something, somewhere secure, you know what I'm saying? But it's really nice. Like, I thought the high was going to be 40 because of the rain, but it stopped raining way before I went to work this morning. So it's really nice. Like, I have the windows down. I'm about to eat, so usually I put up my little window shade when I'm about to consume food or take naps or something. I do have my windows tinted now. But if I did want extra security, I still have those blackout panels that I bought before I had tents. Used to set my car up and take a nap. I love taking a nap in my car on my lunch break. I could go home, but that cuts into like 20 minutes.
Morning, people. So here I am today, and I have a dilemma because my shirts came from Shein, little leopard or whatever print you want to call it. Have a leopard mask on, don't match. None of my leopards or cheetahs are matching. I don't know why I thought this was a good idea. Should have just went for the black, but it's okay. It's completely okay.
At the park, such a beautiful day. There's more people here than usual, I guess because the temperature is so nice. So I brought my lunch with me, and I just have, I don't know what's going on my fork, but there's mixed vegetables, sausage, and broccoli. I still have the lemon pepper in my, what is going on? I still have the lemon pepper in my purse for my broccoli. And that was a little merch. My mixed vegetables. Glad. I haven't even tasted it, but I already know I like lemon pepper. And I knew my fork was gonna break. I guess. Look at this. It just snapped. Maybe my food was too hot. This probably was too hot. Let's go for broccoli. Lemon pepper really set that off. Sausage is still tasty. Honestly, I don't come here a lot, but when I have come, when the weather was nice, over the last few months, it's just really been me. I mean, it's really not been a lot of people out. But now, today, there are so many people here, and I'm like, dang, it's usually quiet. Like, they got the band practicing. I'm like, Jesus. It is beautiful. Let's see. So far, done 0.28 of a mile. See if it gave me a nice little mile in. Very easy pace today. I didn't bring any workout shoes, so I keep getting rocks in my flats, and that sucks. The sun is like over here, but I keep getting rocks in my flats, and yeah, these are just flats. They're not, I don't have that bounce that I usually have, so I'm not trying to be too extra with my walking. I'm getting tired of stopping for rocks. I'm on my way to the gym. I just went home and I had to change. out of my work clothes. I'm heading there now. It's really nice today, and whenever I've noticed, whenever the weather is nice, he usually has I left my knee brace. Freak. No, that's just water in my jacket. My knee brace off when I was changing my clothes, and I didn't put it back on. So I kind of hate when I do that. I mean, my knee has been kind of bothering me today, or just sometimes I feel like it's getting better and other times it just isn't. The first time I met with my orthopedic doctor or whatever, he gave me like this list of workouts that I should do to kind of strengthen my knee and stuff like that, but I haven't done them. And then in January I started working out with my trainer, so that way I've been doing knee stuff, and we've been doing like some leg stuff that involves my knee, but now I really just hate and I don't have my brace, especially if it's bothering me. Like sometimes it feels great and sometimes it doesn't, so I really don't know. And sometimes like I pull my knee brace really tight and that really does like stabilize everything, like the lady was talking about. Because I, for the longest time, I was just wearing a little cheapy knee brace that I bought from CVS. In here, and I'll talk to y'all later. Just got off the elliptical and I did 15 minutes and I did it like a fat burning resistance, so you know I got a little sweat right here. And yeah, so now I'm in the sauna, or the sauna, how you say it? I'm in a sauna, and usually my trainer likes everybody to at least get 15 minutes in the sauna usually at the end of the workout. So I always end my workouts in the sauna, and that's that on that.
Donna, sauna is yours. Oh, this is the light that needs to be changed. Hold on. I could have made that. Don't y'all judge me either. I can eat a little french fry if I want to after leaving the gym. Thank you very much. Mind yours. And I can drink a frappe if I want to, because that's my business. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
If these aren't the nosiest mother truckers, this isn't for you. And what's wrong with your foot, sir? What's wrong with that leg? What's wrong with that foot? They always want something. Like, they think you got to give them something. I don't got to give you nothing. I don't have to give you anything. That breath stink. I'm going to give you a treat. Chill out. He is so excited. Yeah. They have this cute little treat bucket I got from Dollar Tree. It says all my... Sir, can you back up? Thank you. Sir. There you go. Eat your treat. Give Batman a smaller piece. So this jacket is actually my favorite, right? Oh, hold on, put this back up. I was gonna wear this to the gym this morning, but I never packed my workout clothes. Okay, so this is my favorite jacket, right? And it just has a lot of lint on it, and I have been searching, like, how do I get the lint off of a jacket? So today, something just was like, Google it. So I Googled it, and they said that you could use like a little razor. So found this razor. Let me get a baby wipe or something, because they said keep it clean. Y'all, this lint, right? So I have a little razor here. I don't know if y'all gonna be able to tell. Just do it on this part right here. You just... Yeah, it looks a lot better. But not too hard. I have to show y'all before and after. So, we have lint on the sleeve. And I just wore this one sweater. And this one sweater was so linty. And it was here to stay. Today we are having broccoli. I think this is brown rice and chicken. And I have my lemon pepper to go on my broccoli, maybe on this. So bon appetit.
I am heading to do some walking. It's just nice. And it feels good to just, when the weather is nice, I think it's warmer than it was yesterday too. So I'm super excited. Lunch was amazing. It was really good. Like that rice with the broccoli. And this chicken was just prepared different. And I'm here for it. It was really good. I very much appreciate that meal. It's definitely more quiet today. I'm telling y'all, yesterday, so many people were here. And I'm like, what the heck? I just grabbed my little key, my car key. Okay, so I have my key, got my AirPods, and take you guys. I did not forget shoes this time. I actually put them in the car yesterday when I left my gym clothes at home. So I went ahead and grabbed some shoes to wear. So these I got from Burlington. No, I lied. These are Nautica, and I got them from Ross. They're just a really nice basic black shoe. I like to wear them with other outfits too. So much quieter and peaceful today. This is what I live for, the quiet. Honey, we are leaving. Thank you. That was a very good walk. Very good. And now, that was a great 30 minute walk that I just did. I was able to get a mile and a half done. A mile and a half was done. It's funny, there was this older guy on the track as well. And he was like, on my last time around, literally on my last lap, he was like, you are killing it, because every time I make one loop around, you've done two. And I was just laughing like, you're right, sir. I only have a short amount of time. I have to get back to work. The air just feels so good through my scalp. Like, that's something that I love about being natural. Like, just feeling that in your scalp. Like, oh my goodness. Could love listening to the Ramsey Show. They changed it. It used to be the Dave Ramsey Show, but since he always has like co-hosts and stuff, he changed the name. I think it was this month they decided to change the name to the Ramsey Show, and it's so good. And I'm on the baby steps plan, and I'm trying to get out of debt. And the debt that I have is student loans and a car note, and those are both negative forms of debt. I know people, probably many of you, are gonna carry your student loans to your grave, or you're gonna make minimum payments, or if you're a government worker, you're going to hold them, make 120 payments, and then have the loans forgiven. And that's cool, do you, boo. But these student loans are not going to be a debt owed by me in 2 years. Shoot, even they should be finished at the end of this year. I'm doing everything in my power to get these loans away from me. And I don't even have to actually make a payment yet. I'm in a grace period because I graduated, but I'm still in school with my degree, getting another degree. So they're still prolonged before I actually have to make a payment. But I started paying on them last year. As of April, I think April 20th or something of 2020, I owed $29,000 in student loans. Guess how much I owe now? $18,000. Last year and the beginning of this year, I was able to pay over $10,000 in student loans. It was conditioned that student loans were just normal to get, but also people don't pay it back as well, which is fine. I mean, if you can get loan forgiveness, I was going to do a whole video about this, but if you are able to get loan forgiveness, but you're still making 120 payments. Like, so far, I've only made 26 payments. I have to hold those student loans for 10 years to get the student loan forgiveness. If that's what y'all want to do, so be it. But I would just rather get out of debt. I mean, just get it away from my name. Go ahead and pay it. As well, like, in November, I also refinanced my car. My credit, when I first got this car, I didn't really have credit. I just had student loans and no credit, no nothing. So yeah, I had a really high interest rate, like 16%, 16.54%. And I refinanced my car. It's not the lowest, it's not the lowest interest rate, but it's a 6.4%. That shaved off a whole 10% of interest on my car. And I owe less. I mean, my car is still worth more than I owe on it. And every month, like my month, like I used to pay $330 on my car note. Now I pay $210. Like, I don't know. Like, it's, everything is going in a great direction. All because I've started paying my student loans. Now, nowadays, I don't really give a crap about credit. Like, credit doesn't mean nothing to me. If I can't buy it in cash, I don't want it. If I can't afford to pay for it in cash, I don't want it. It's not for me. I mean, not including the house, but if I can't buy it in cash, I don't want it. So that's where we at right now. That's my journey. Yeah, I try to talk about it as much as I can to anybody who's listening. If y'all haven't seen my video on student loans, watch it, because I made it last year after I had started this payment process of myself. You have a loan, don't get no more. Don't get no more. Also, now I'm paying for school out of pocket. Like, I pay for my school out of pocket. I make payments. Okay, I swipe my card when it's time for me to pay tuition. And I understand that everyone is not able, but eventually these people can start taking money out your check if you're behind in these payments. Paying the minimum, like the interest goes up so high. I mean, not the interest, but the amount of accrued interest increases so much. Your loans end up being double and triple the amount. And I didn't like that. I didn't like that at all. That doesn't sit right with my spirit. Like, but that's how America works. So I hope Papa Joe, it would be nice if he did do something with $10,000 these student loans. Because, honey, please, please, if you just give me 10. I mean, if you give me 10, that's fine. I'm not going to refuse no money. Granted that I'm trying to pay for it myself, but I'm not going to refuse no money, honey. Do you hear me? I am not. Where's my earring? Y'all, how long has my earring been missing? Y'all wasn't gonna tell me to keep a backup pair of earrings, but how long have I gone? I knew I just wasn't looking. I wasn't feeling right today. I'm here missing a whole earring. That looks so much better from this angle. Y'all could have just told me. Dang. Thought we was better friends than that. Y'all don't say nothing. Well, we'll continue this conversation in another video. I wanted to do some real life topics. I was making a video about the student loan repayment thing, so if y'all are really interested in that, let me know, because if I haven't started filming it before the vlog comes out, then y'all will be getting that if you're interested. I was just going over like student loan forgiveness and the stats on that, because honey, it's like 1% of the hundreds of thousands of people who have applied. 1%. So I'm just saying, actually, I think it's only like 2,000 people out of 100,000. So, I mean, y'all can depend on it if you want to. Go ahead, but I'm just saying, you may be disappointed after waiting 10 years.
What do you do, people? Okay, so I'm heading. You already know where I'm going.
A little warmer than expected today. Lord, why are these chairs so hot? I got on black. Jesus. Trying something new, but it's a little too hot for your girl. I was gonna eat at my desk, but I'm eating fish today, and I know y'all have seen those memes where people like be warming up fish in the office. I don't want to be one of them. So I said, let me bring it out. Found more of a corner. The only seat was this one over there too. So in a little corner so the sun is not hitting your girl like that, because phew, it's a lot of sun. It's very beautiful though. I really just discovered this little balcony area, because usually I go down to like the first floor or something. I didn't even know these little balcony. I didn't know how people got to these, and I figured it out one day and I was like, I'm gonna start going over there.
Gonna go do a little walking. I'm trying to do as much walking as I can while the weather is warm, even though I go to the gym today. But it feels so good. It's 76, but it feels, my car is like reporting 79. I don't even have on pants today. Good thing I wore these biker shorts. But I went looking in my trunk and I found a t-shirt, a hat. This sun is so hot, so I'm putting on a t-shirt and a hat and wear that. And I found my little blackout curtains, because I'm gonna have to change in my car to just not waste any more time. So that's good. Like, I do have like a little overnight bag in my car, but it's literally overnight. Like, it has like shorts to wear, which I could have put the shorts on, but I already have the biker shorts on and they're longer, so they'll just be a better fit with what I got going on. So yeah, my life is just so mundane right now. And honestly, even though it kind of may seem like I'm at a pretty stable point for the most part, like, I'm still in school, and last night I was doing my homework and it was so hard. I mean, I guess honestly I don't really understand the material, so I was just trying to figure it out, but it really wasn't working. It wasn't helping. Like, the first three questions, cool, I didn't get all the points on them, but I mean, I got 3 points for that. But like, I made a 3 out of 10. I made a 30 on that homework, basically a one-time extension. But this is homework, whatever, and I just don't know if I want to use it on that one. Like, it could be a much harder homework down the line. But I'm gonna have to learn that material though. So what I'm gonna do is go in and, I don't know, I didn't even talk to him about it. Like, so it's kind of like I'm struggling on my own. But he does record the lessons, so what I need to do is watch the lesson again and I should be okay.
And we're off. Can't believe I left my AirPods on my desk. Have on me a Freedom shirt from when I went to the Freedom Conference with Church of the Highlands. I know so many hats in my car. Like, I have so many hats in the house. Did not know so many more were in my car.
I actually did go pick up my cupcakes. Y'all, I'm really trying. Y'all not understanding. Y'all probably like, Tommie, what are you doing? I'm trying.
New day, new vlog. Don't worry about this Apple Watch charger around my neck, okay? We're not here to focus on that. But I'm walking the doggies and I'm waiting for Bono to go so I can go where I gotta go. I put it in my planner to basically wash my sheets and bedding and all the blankets today, and I'm gonna take them to the laundromat because I don't know, that just seems like so much washing to do at home. And also, my aunt, honestly, y'all, let me tell y'all, I don't actually wash clothes at my house. My aunt prefers to wash all the clothes. She's pretty particular about her washer. She's had some lasting mishaps from other people to where she doesn't like any and everybody using her washer. And any and everybody also includes me, who has lived in that house for 24 years. Or not 24 years, for at least 20 years. So you always doing something. Stay out of them woods. Like, if you get tangled up in there. Come on, bat boy. Come on. How much does I have to tell you? How many times, sir? How many times? Hope it gets brighter because it looks pretty gloomy. Always doing something. But after I wash, my next plan, what else do I have to do? Oh, I'm going to the gym. And I need to make a Walmart trip later in the day. And then I think I'm going to do a little dashing. But while I wait for my laundry, I will be studying in the car. That's what I did, I think, last time I went to the laundromat. I studied a little bit in the car just to... And I think I was able to complete a section and everything. I've actually already done the lecture for the part that I'm on. But I will finish this chapter this weekend. I will finish it. I don't care what it takes. I will mother truck and finish it. Because Tommie, get it together. Get it together. I also, I have some video ideas surrounding career. Because I know that's kind of the focus I want my channel to move in. Besides, like, just out of college stuff. Like, I'm not doing college content anymore. Like, college morning routine or stuff like that. Like, I'll do an adult or work life morning routine, but not in this space. But I'll do that maybe next year and stuff like that. Just a new start on being on my own. If I am alone, my family actually kind of wants to move with me across the country to just see how it is. I mean, my auntie owns her home, so she can really just pack up her stuff and like go. House is paid for, so she doesn't have to worry about mortgage or anything attached to where she would have to like let the house go or something. Like, nah. I don't know if I want my family to be with me though, but I don't know. It'd probably be a little less scary in a big city. Batman has swindled his way with me. Yeah, like, okay, we do have a new foster child at the house, and Batman is not a fan. Auntie told me yesterday that Batman was actually hiding in her bathroom, and she could not find him, and he was in her bathroom just hiding from the little boy. He is very rambunctious, very a busybody, if you will, and a busybody, basically, and he basically yeah, like Bono, a lot of the time Bono is growling at him, barking at him, and he's warning him. Bono's warning him, hey, leave me alone. And he doesn't get it. Like, he ignores all the barks and the little like stuff that Bono's doing to warn him. Like, he's just ignoring it. And we keep telling the little boy, like, hey, how would you like if somebody kept bothering you when you're just trying to relax? And he doesn't care. I mean, he's a kid. They only think about themselves. So trying to teach him, like, leave the dog alone. When he tells you, when he does that, he's telling you he doesn't want to play. So Batman was like, please take me with you, please. So we have Bat Boy as happy as she can be. Just along. This was a struggle, but we got all the washers filled. Got the comforter going. My sheets and stuff. My work clothes.
my trainer wants me to do 2 laps around the block. Bruh, that's not what I had in mind for today. If I do a little jog run won't hurt nobody. Sauna time. Do y'all see this? Glisten. I'm truly upset because I have not been making good money doing Uber Eats and DoorDash today. Honestly, usually, it's not the app's fault. Popeyes are just slow as freak. Over here trying to earn extra income, you know. But Popeyes takes forever. They always do. This was not... These people are supposed to have their food by 314, 321. It's 341. Every Popeyes I go to, I'm going to stop accepting orders from here. Like, I'm going to stop because it makes no sense. And I missed out. So, also, while I do DoorDash, I do Uber Eats at the same time, which I've said before. I know I have. But in that process, I have missed out on so many Uber Eats orders because of these... Ooh, like annoying DoorDashes. And my Uber Eats wants me like 22, and you know, some of them be 11, 12, which is fine, because usually on a DoorDash order I'm making 8, I'm making 9, 9.75, something like that. It's honestly rare that an order be over like $10, and I try to accept. When I was first doing DoorDash and I didn't really like it, I wouldn't do anything less than 5. But the miles have to be less than the pay, basically. Or it can't be more miles than it is pay, which makes sense. And I honestly, before, I wasn't really paying attention to that. But if something is like paying you $5 and it's 11 miles, like you at least want a dollar a mile, which I'll do a whole video about. So I've been extra strategic now with the way that I accept orders. I haven't been getting paid today, and I've only done DoorDash orders, and because I've been on these DoorDash orders, I've missed out on great Uber Eats orders. And sometimes it is best just stick with one app in that regard, but sometimes it works out. Like last night, I did both. I did Uber Eats and DoorDash. I did a single Uber Eats order, a single order on Uber Eats, and made $40 on one order. They was like, we'll pay you $23. Oh. Hi.
Hey, how you doing?
Good. Sorry, I didn't expect the lady. So this footage is probably going to be weird right here. Oh, I can't even talk to y'all. I need to get back on the app. Y'all, I am out here, just finished a delivery order. And I've come, okay, this is a really nice neighborhood. And there's a gate that you have to go through to get in. It's so dark on that side, but I'm telling y'all, these homes are literally beautiful. Like, oh my goodness, like y'all need to see. Like, I don't know if y'all are seeing these homes. Should I turn my brightness on? Wait, I don't think that helps. Ooh. But do y'all see this house? Like, look at this house. Okay, are y'all seeing this house? I'm hoping the guy, I talked to him, I hope he tips well, because I told him his order was gonna be delayed. I double triple checked it, so hopefully, you know, they leave a tip. So earlier today I was telling y'all that it wasn't working out and today was bad. It's good, it's been a good day. Sometimes it's just a little slow picking up, but all in all, I hit my goal. I'm over my goal, so I've set a new goal. I'm supposed to stop at 5, but Pizza Company downtown, every time I get an order from them, no lie, I'm there for almost a dang hour, but I'm getting paid a lot of money. It doesn't matter, I'm always getting tipped really good to deliver from that restaurant, which is cool. So I'd be like, okay, because I know that usually I make good money there, I'm not too complaining. But it does take a minute. So yeah,
I just met another delivery person, and I was asking her, she was with Grubhub, but I was just like, do you use like a mile tracker app? And she was like, no, should I? And I was like, well, I use one, and you know, it tracks mileage deduction and yada yada. I just be liking to talk to people. But I encouraged her to get the app, and she downloaded it, and I told her it was good for tax purposes, for mileage deduction and do deductions, because sometimes I have to go through tolls and stuff, and I want all that to be calculated. So I told her about that, and it tracks your earnings from every app, which again, we'll go through it. So I was just telling her about it, being helpful like I try to be. But it was really cool. So now I really need to go home, but see if I can get one more good Uber Eats order, and that'll put me at my new goal, and we'll talk about it in that video.